A month has passed since Bitcoin Miami 2021, which was called the largest crypto event in history. Over 12,000 attendees, 100 expert speakers, and some of the most well-known faces in crypto brought Bitcoin to the forefront of the world's attention. The sheer size of Bitcoin 2021 showed mainstream adoption is well underway and demonstrated the progress that Bitcoin has made since its inception. Bitcoin 2021 was held at Wynwood, Miami, a unique neighborhood known for its colorful murals, eclectic bars, trendy boutiques, and hipster coffee shops.
Welcome to the Miami Wynwood Art District. This area was founded in 2003 by a group of art dealers and has been absolutely revitalized in the years recent. Anything from graffiti on the side of buildings, to the sidewalks, to the streets, this area has come to life and is home to the 2021 Miami Bitcoin Conference.
Unsurprisingly, a major theme at Bitcoin 2021 was non-fungible tokens, or NFTs. There was an entire NFT art gallery at the event which displayed Bitcoin-themed artwork from 35 different creators. Crypto artists like Taylor Good, also known as Warhodl, and Sergey Gordinko, the Do What You Love artist, had large displays of their artwork featured within the gallery. We were informed by the organizers that almost 100 works of art were sold during the event. Art wasn't the only thing you could buy with crypto at Bitcoin 2021.
You can even buy your drinks here at the conference with Bitcoin.
The bar also accepted Bitcoin as payment for drinks. While a fun concept, this feature was completely impractical because the payment transaction fees were higher than the prices of the drinks.
All right, so we tried to pay with our Bitcoin, but the transaction fee cost too much. So unfortunately, we're using our card because convenience is king.
In addition to Bitcoin 2021, the Shitcoin 2021 conference took place on June 3rd through the 4th down the street at the Mana Wynwood. According to the Shitcoin 2021 website, the event was dedicated to all the companies that got turned away from participating at Bitcoin 2021 for not being BTC focused. Bitcoin 2021 was also the first Bitcoin event to take place in person since the start of the COVID-19 pandemic. But while the turnout was impressive, many participants ended up catching the virus as a result of the conference's loose health safety measures. COVID aside, Miami seemed to be the perfect place to host Bitcoin 2021. Miami Mayor Frances Suarez is taking a number of initiatives to ensure Miami becomes the world's next crypto hub, such as proposing legislation that would allow Miami citizens to pay taxes with crypto. The event wrapped up with a special pre-recorded announcement from El Salvador President Nayib Bukele. Bitcoin was adopted as legal tender in El Salvador. With this capstone, Bitcoin 2021 cemented itself as a milestone event in crypto history.
In El Salvador, we are trying to rescue this idea and start the design of a country for the future, using the best ingredients that makes us who we are, while using sensibility to find the best examples of ideas from history and around the world. I believe Bitcoin could be one of these ideas. That is why next week, I will send to Congress a bill that will make Bitcoin a legal tender in El Salvador.
Hit the subscribe button to get notified for our upcoming in-depth video analysis of El Salvador's Bitcoin law later this month.
It's Rachel here at Bitcoin 2021, and we are wrapping up, and this has been a crazy, amazing event. Let me just tell you guys, after all these years of going to Bitcoin conferences, this has been one of the very best that I have ever attended. The speakers at this conference have been incredible, very big names, very informative panels. We've got so many great interviews with speakers like Alex Mashinsky, Yoni from eToro. So it's just been so much fun, and I can't wait to watch all the panels all over again. And thank you for joining us.
Cointelegraph editor-at-large John Rice also shared his thoughts after the event.
So Bitcoin 2021 has been an interesting conference because I think people forget to a large extent that we're a small community in the global scheme of things, and we sometimes feel kind of alone. You know, we don't always know that there's a Bitcoiner next door or 10 Bitcoiners on our block. So I think when you get to an event like this and you see thousands of other people who are trying to do the same thing as we are, which is basically change a big thing with a small number of people, it makes you feel less alone. It makes you feel more like you're part of a community. And to that extent, I think Bitcoin 21 has proved that we are here as a part of a celebration. It's not just a conference, it's a celebration of something we believe in, something we feel is important as a community, and the kind of perennial struggle of a small group of people against an establishment. So when you look around here and you see, you know, hundreds of people, if you don't know them or if you aren't even learning from them because you already know much a whole ton about Bitcoin, it doesn't really matter, because what it's reinforcing to you is you are not alone. There are other people who believe what you do, and there are other people who feel it's important.